if they will just turn, says he will restore the hearts of the fathers to their children and the hearts of the children to their fathers, saying, I'm going to help them understand what it is to be in the will of God, he says. But if they don't hear me, says Malachi, says the Lord is sending Elijah so that he would not have to, watch what the book says, smite the land with the curse. The word curse simply means ban. And I don't know about you, but I would not want to be banned from the Lord. I think we take this thing too lightly of serving God. We think that it's a kind of Burger King kind of relationship. We can have it our way. That's why we kind of read when we feel like it. We kind of study when it's convenient. I'll go to church if I feel up to it today. No, it's too deep for me to just choose and decide when I feel like serving God. But if I don't feel like it, God knows my heart. That is the problem. That's the problem. God knows our hearts. So Malachi says, if you are faithful to God when this day comes, and I don't know about you, but I'm glad I'm in this crowd. And today is a good day to make sure that you are in this crowd that will dance and have joy like the calf, because there is a day that's coming. It's a promise. Whether we accept it or not, it is a promise. He is coming back again. We don't like to talk about it, but he is coming back again. And when he comes back again, Malachi is talking to them. He says, he's sending Elijah before this terrible day so that he can turn the hearts of fathers back to children, the hearts of children back to fathers, so that he does not have to smite the land with a curse. That's heavy oil. But he gives us joy all through this book, by showing us that God is a God that gives us opportunity after opportunity. All through this book, you've seen how the Jews have been arguing with Malachi when in essence they've been arguing with God. Can I just digress for a minute? Can I just say this parenthetically? When you spend time arguing with the mouthpiece of God, you are really arguing with God. When they were spending time fighting against Malachi, they were in essence fighting against God. Somebody's gonna catch it on their way home when they get on 95. It's gonna sink in, because I don't have to say it. I want you to just kind of read between the lines today. I want you to kind of get that on your way home, to just hear what I said. When they fought against Malachi, they were in essence boxing with God. But look at how good God is. All the way in chapter 4, at the end of the book, Malachi is still trying to give them a perspective and saying to them that what God has promised is going to come to pass. Says there is a day that's going to come. And he says, now what's going to happen is this. Those who are not right with God, this will be their ultimate fate. Those who are right with God, this will be their ultimate fate. The moment I heard Malachi saying that, I would have said, Malachi, what must I do to be saved? And I say to us today that there is coming a day. The old warriors would say, we will have to pack up hymn books and Bibles to study war no more. We are going to have to leave this side. But the question is, when the coming day of the Lord comes, which side will you be on? Malachi says, for those who are faithless, they are going to have to deal with judgment. But for those who are faithful, they will be the recipients of joy. For those who are faithless, they will have to deal with sorrow. But for those who are faithful, they will understand the blessings of God. And I don't know about you, but I want to be in the faithful crowd. So when the Lord comes back, I don't have to worry about all of the negative stuff. I don't have to worry about all of the judgment and the difficulty, but I'll be able to just embrace him and thank God that he has me in his care. And I want to encourage somebody in the room. I really didn't mean to go this far, but I want to encourage somebody in the room that you need to understand that when the day comes, you will have joy. Because you won't have to deal with all of the oppression of the wicked. And I heard the folk of old say, we're going to a place where the wicked shall cease from troubling. And the weary shall be at rest. Is there anybody here going to go with me to that place where the wicked shall cease from troubling? And the weary shall be at rest. I can't imagine the pain and the anguish that Malachi had to deal with week in and week out, having to deal with folk who did not want to hear the word of God. But I found out a few years ago when the Lord called me to preach his word, there were those that I would preach the truth to, but they would still live any kind of way. But Malachi says, and I say to us today, there is a coming day of the Lord. And I want to help somebody right here. I don't want to scare you, but I want to encourage you. There is a coming day of the Lord. I don't want to put fear in your heart, but I want you to be God fearers. There will be a day coming of the Lord. And when that day comes, will you be ready? When the Lord shows up, I don't know about you in the room right now, but I thank God I got fixed up a long time ago. So whenever he showed up, I realized that I'm on the winning side. And I'm going to go with him to see my Lord. Is there anybody here? Is there anybody here going to go with him? I want to encourage you right now. Don't worry about the pain that this life is presenting you. Don't worry about the trouble that this life is giving you. One of these old days, and it won't be very long, soon and very soon, we are going to see the King. Is there anybody here ready to go see the King? Is there anybody here ready to go see the King? Is there anybody here getting ready to go see the Lord? And I thank God that he's given us another chance. So every one of us ought to tell somebody about the goodness of the Lord. Every one of us ought to tell somebody about the man named Jesus. Tell them that he's coming back again. I know we've been preaching this years on end, but he is coming back again. Is there anybody here believe that he's coming back again? So I'm getting ready each and every day of my life. I'm getting ready because he's coming back. Is there anybody here know that he's coming back? Shake your neighbor's hand and say, neighbor, you want to get ready? Tell a neighbor, you ought to get ready. He's coming back. Yes, he is. Is there anybody here believe that he's coming back? You ought to tell somebody if you're ready. Tell them, I'm ready. Whenever he comes back, I'm ready. Whenever he showed up, I'm ready. Yes, Lord. Each and every day, I'm getting better and better. Each and every day, I'm spending more time in his word because I understand that when he showed up, I don't want to be in the crowd that is banned, but I want to be in the crowd that's blessed. Is there anybody here know that you will be in the blessed crowd. And if you're saved, I'm not talking about just a church member. If you're saved, I'm not just talking about somebody that's singing in the choir. If you're saved, I'm not just talking about somebody who says that they have a calling on their life. But if you're saved, I'm talking about some folk in a right relationship with God. Saved, saved, saved. Is there anybody here know that you know? Know that you know, know that you know that you've been saved. I'm talking about some folk who's not shaken when you're mistreated, but you still hang on to your salvation. I'm talking about some saved folk who understand that when the Savior comes back, you'll just stand there waiting on him, understanding that when he showed up, you're already fixed up. Is there anybody here? Is there anybody here? Know that you have a mansion in the sky. Thank you, John, for telling us that he's prepared a place for prepared people. Is there anybody here? Know you have your life prepared. If you know you are prepared, you can shout in this sermon. If you know your life is fixed up, you can shout right here. Is there anybody here? Anybody here? Anybody here? Anybody here? No, you've been saved. Say yes. Say yes. Say yes. Yeah. Oh, yes, anybody know you've been saved? Know you've been saved? Know you've been saved? Know you've been saved? Say yes! Yes, know you've been saved. Been saved, sure been saved. I want to go on some more. I feel it all in my spirit. Sure been saved, sure been saved, sure been saved. I know I've been. He's coming back again. I know we don't hear those kind of sermons much. He's coming back again. Are you ready? Are you ready? Say yeah! 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 Ah! So glad I've been saved.